Learn Excel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 2450, Creating Excel Custom Data Types from Power BI. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I've been fascinated with these data types that they introduced several years ago. They're actually kind of on version 2, so I can choose a cell here and say that this is music. Gets converted to a linked data type, and then using the card, I can come in and let's say find members. I can add all of the members to the grid. So not just a single entity, but an array of entities, and they're not just coming in as text. Each one is coming in as a linked data type, and I can get, let's say, information from that linked data type. And even because this in B1 is an array, if I add the spill operator, it will retrieve all of the images except for Carlton Barrett, who for some reason they don't have the images. All right, now this is interesting. These are party tricks here, right? What we really need is our own company data in these data types. When we achieve that, and when it is as rich as this, where we can store an entire array, return an array of entities. From the entities, get data. My vision is that once we can get our own data in data types, all of this other stuff will just go away. These are all party tricks, right? Getting data from Wikipedia, you know, that's like, remember when Power Query was brand new? Everyone who did a Power Query demo would go out and pull something in from Wikipedia. No one does that today. Getting your own company data, that will be really valuable. And once they achieve this, I don't think we'll ever go back to, you know, geography. Maybe currency exchange rates, maybe stocks, you know, but pulling Wikipedia data in, you know, who trusts Wikipedia data? It was a great 2 or 3 year proof of concept of what's possible. As soon as they give us our own data, yeah, we'll never go back. So I already have one video on this, on how to use a linked data type from Power Query. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do this with Power BI. Tomorrow, though, I'm going to show you the future. Let's get started. All right, so here I have a workbook. This is called Book Catalog. This is our own company data. These are all the books that we publish, book title, author. And you'll notice sometimes there's two of them. That's going to cause problems. ISBN, publish date. I broke out just the first author so I could try and create a linked data type. I have the URL, and further out, I have the image URL. There's a second sheet here. This is, by the way, let's see, called, this is a table called books. I have a second sheet with a table called authors, book authors, so name, URL. And I've done file save as and save this to my OneDrive. So if I go into file info and copy the path, I really want to see that. How can I see that? So let's go to Notepad. When I paste that path, that's the complete path, along with this question mark web equals one. Right, and we're going to have to throw away that web equals one when we go into Power BI. So everything before that is what we want to use. All right, so that's the data in Excel. We want to get this data to be a new data type in the data types gallery. We're going to fire up Power BI Desktop. And I'll create a new report. Close this and go to get data. From web. I know it seems like it's an Excel workbook, but it's an Excel workbook stored on the web. And we paste in that URL. All right, make sure to get rid of the question mark. Choose OK. All right, now it didn't ask me to authenticate, and that's probably because I'm already signed in. I think the first time that I did this, I had to put in my, my Microsoft user ID and password. And so we want are the two tables, books and book authors. I'll simply load those. All right, we're gonna come take a look at the data. So over here on the left-hand side. All right, and a couple of bits of cleanup here. So we're in the authors table. I click on URL and the data category is a web URL. Good, and then over here I'll click on books. The URL here, again, I'll say that this is a web URL and the image URL. All right, Good. And then here, I wonder if we can create a relationship. Well, the data types understand the relationship. So from first author right here, that's the one that has a single name to the name. And they figured out that's a one-to-many relationship. And then I'm going to click on book authors. All right. And this is the important part. This is how you get this table to be in the data types entity. Over here on the properties pane, I'm going to say is a feature table and choose yes. This is a list of book authors. The important row label is name. That's what will be displayed by default. And the key column is also name. Click save. All right, there we go, success. And then books, let's click on that one. And we want to make that be a feature table. So this is a list of our products. If you open this, I want the book title and the key column, again, should be book title. All right, cool. Click save and success. All right. Now we need to publish this to a new workspace. I hadn't used Power BI in a while and I had just published it to the workspace that I've been using years ago and that didn't work. So I had to create a brand new workspace, publish. Let's see, we'll save our changes. New one that I created is called Mr. Excel. We'll select. Success. All right, that's great. I'm back in Excel. Go to the data tab, open this up, and wow, check it out. It's already there. I didn't even have to restart Excel. So I have a book title over in A2. I choose books, and it recognized that there's two of them. All right, so we want this one. Select. All right, that's freaking awesome, right? And then I can get the cover image. Beautiful. Just make it taller and we'll see it. Nice. That works great. Let me get the author. Where's the little icon? I want to drill down and get the URL for Mike. How come that's not working? Let's see. Down here I have the URL. Let's add that. That's not the image URL. That's the actual URL. And that does not come in as a link. I'll try and add .link. That sometimes works with regular URLs. Doesn't know it. Nope. You know, and then getting the author to be an entity, you know, it feels like I'm going to have to come up here and then choose books author. No. You can't convert a formula into an entity. It looks like we're shut down here. All right, look, this is better than the Power Query data types, but it's still not there. It's not the goal of being able to have a data type, an entity that returns another entity, that returns a field. We're not there yet. Closer. Make sure to check out tomorrow, where I think we'll see the future. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.